क्रतुंड महाकाय
ನಮ್ಮಂತ ಹೆಣ್ಮಕ್ಳಿಗೆಲ್ಲ ಒಳ್ಳೇದಾಗ್ಲಿ ಮೋಟಿವೇಶನ್ ಆಗಲಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಗಣಪತಿ ಆಚಾರ್ಯ ಗುರುಜಿ ಅವರು ಇವತ್ತು ನಮ್ಮ ಜೊತೆಯಲ್ಲಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ನಮಿತಾ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್ ಅವರು ನಮ್ಮ ಜೊತೆಯಲ್ಲಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಆಸ್ ಎ ಸಕ್ಸಸ್ಫುಲ್ ವುಮೆನ್.
ಹಾಂ, ನಮಿತಾ ಗುಪ್ತಾ ಅವ್ರನ್ನ ನಾನು ನಿಮಗೆಲ್ಲ ಪರಿಚಯಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ. ತುಂಬಾ ಇವರಿಂದ ನೀವು ಕಲ್ತ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಹೆಣ್ಮಕ್ಳಿಗೆ ಇವರೊಂದು ಸ್ಫೂರ್ತಿ. ಇವರು ನಮ್ಮ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರಲ್ಲಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಇವರು ನಮ್ಮ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕದಲ್ಲಿದೆ ಅನ್ನೋದು ನಮಗೆ ಹೆಮ್ಮೆ.
Hello, ma'am.
Hi, Mansa. How are you?
I'm good, ma'am.
Very good. Very good. Thank you so much for coming.
Yeah, ma'am. Today we are with Namita Gupta. She's a Bangalore Rich Magazine editor.
Yeah.
Ma'am, how was your journey, ma'am?
So I moved to Bangalore about 25 years back. Huh? And my parents moved here on work. And I did my master's in English from Bangalore University, Gyan Bharati campus, you know, it's very far from here. And so after that I joined a dot-com. It was a dot-com boom going on. So I was doing content writing for them. And then I came to know somebody was looking for an editor for a jewelry magazine. So I went and approached them and they liked my work. And I was just lucky to have gotten a job with a jewelry magazine as an editor. So I would say, you know, I started right up there and I was lucky. I learned a lot on the job. It was good and met a lot of interesting celebrities. We interviewed Hema Malini ji and Yana Gupta and, you know, a lot of big jewelers, celebrities. It was handling a whole national magazine every month. And we used to get content from across the country. And managing a team of reporters and designers was good. The magazine is still there. So I took a little break in between. I had two children. I have a girl and a boy. Of course, now they are big. My daughter is 18. My son is 13. So my daughter is in college. She's doing psychology. My son is in
nice
school.
Nice combination.
Yeah. So, and then when they grew up a little bit, I joined a newspaper. I was working for Midday, Bangalore. Bangalore had an edition of Midday. I started with a senior correspondent, then I became features editor. And I was there for like 5 years. And then I joined another paper called Deccan Chronicle. I was there for another 5.5 years. And recently, about 6 months back, I joined Ritz Magazine as the editor for Bangalore. And my job involves, you know, meeting a lot of influential people, socialites, celebrities who are doing well in their big, you know, their work. And it's a luxury magazine, so it's a lot of food, fashion, art, music, travel.
Fashion is more,
fashion, yeah, accessories, travel, and a lot of other interesting things. I handle the website also. So
how did you maintain the family and the work?
You know, being in this profession, it's not easy to to balance both family life and work life. It's sometimes a little taxing, but you know, you have to really prioritize what is important. So once my family is taken care of, my mind is there on my work. You know, I know that of course my priority is my family. And thankfully, they've all been very supportive. My parents, my husband, my children, everybody is very, very supportive. So because of that, I'm able to really concentrate on my work. And, you know, our head office is in Chennai and our boss, Aruna, is a very, very sweet, independent lady herself. So because of that, I'm really able to, you know, give my best to whatever I do. And yeah.
For a successful woman, we need a support from the husband.
Yeah. Husband does like a wife to do everything for her. And you do have to. That's fine. That's part of your, you know, it's all right to do all that. But at the same time, they are there to support you in whatever you do. It's a balance, right? You have to maintain. You support him and he supports you. So you go along, it's otherwise, you know, your boat will go upside down and, you know, you're not...
Obviously, the husband sees like some restrictions.
No, he never, thankfully, he never had any restrictions. yeah, touch wood, you know. He was always very sweet. He always trusted me wherever I was going. Even if I had to travel on work, he was fine. He would take care of the house and kids. So it was,
yeah. It's a great thing.
It was good, yeah.
For a successful woman, the parent support should be must and should. How your parents supported you in the beginning?
Yes, definitely. I think parents have to be very supportive. You know, you're talking about girl child,
yeah.
And how, you know, earlier days it was different. But my mother was still always a working woman, even in her times.
What she would
she,
do?
She was a teacher. She was an English lecturer and very independent. She's also done her master's in English. And she's the one who really pushed me to go get my education done. You know, and thanks to her, in those days, you know, we all take it very lightly. We don't really realize how in the long run it will help us. So she really helped me do my best. I completed my master's in English with very good marks. And then she also pursued me to do an MBA, which I've also done in from St. Joseph's College, yeah. And I've done a journalism course from Symbiosis.
Oh, wow.
So she really told me that, yes, you must continue doing, you know, complete your studies. And so the same way I now tell my daughter, of course, she's very grounded. I don't really need to push her, but these days the kids are very smart, you know. They don't really need to be pushed. But every woman should work. It's very important for their career, and at the end of the day, it gives them satisfaction that they've done something. And I've seen that working mothers' children get more independent in life. You know, it's they don't look up to their parents for support all the time. Of course, parents are there to support them, but they have to be independent, right? And that's very important
it's
in today's times. Yes.
In this generation,
yes,
especially.
Yes. So my mother was very supportive from the beginning, and the same way I've been supportive to my daughter. But, you know, I think every mother, every woman should work so that, you know, their kids get independent. They realize that it is important that they find their true potential, and it gives them satisfaction at the end of the day, and you know, they go out in the world, they get their exposure, the way how they think. You can see a stark difference.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And two words about your father.
My father was always busy in his work. So, but always he was a topper at IIT Delhi, and he went to the US to do his master's. So he was an inspiration always. He was, you know, a topper in college. I could never match that kind of studies. But my brother kept up to his level of, you know, he also did his engineering from the US. So, yeah.
Well, what is success according to you?
So success for me is, you know, you don't have to sacrifice one thing to get the other. You always should have a good balance in life. And, you know, it's not easy to for women to be successful. You know, you don't have to sacrifice your family life to be successful in work, or you have to, you know, the other way.
Continue.
Shouldn't be, you know, none of them should be, you know, sacrificed. Both of them have to be balanced. So I feel the best way to achieve success is to have a good balance of your professional as well as family life, personal life, and to have, you know, to give yourself time as well. It's very important.
I've seen so many girls for success, they'll drop something and like family only.
Oh yes, and especially in my field, I've seen a lot of single women, a lot of women without children. They're not even willing to have children. After they cross a certain age.
Very late.
Yeah, and they're so focused on their work, they don't want to have children. I'm not saying having children is very important, but what I'm saying is you should have a healthy, balanced family life. It's not that I'm always very, you know, happy, and, you know, my kids are very happy, I'm very happy. Also, there are, you know, times we also struggle. Ups and downs. Everybody goes through their highs and lows. There are times when people expect you to, you know, give so much at home, and you're not able to. And there are times when people expect you to do things at work, but But then that's the way it is. That's the way life is. You have to put in your best and you know your potential. You know you can do it. So just go out and do it. That's it. There's no other way. I think just go and do.
What keeps you motivated and what's your motivation? Who is your motivation?
So, you know, one can find motivation in everyday things of life. But, you know, for me, every time I feel down, I feel a little low, I tell myself, you know, I'm complaining about something as small as, you know, working a little more sometimes. But there are so many people who would die to get into my shoes, who would die to do what I'm doing today. And, you know, a lot of my friends tell me, oh, wow, you met this celebrity, you met this star, you met Salman Khan, or you interviewed Kajal Agarwal, or, you know, somebody as big as them. And, you know, you go out, you meet interesting people, you're out there, and I'm complaining about something as small as this, then I tell myself, then I push myself, that pushes me to, you know, go further. And, you know, that's what keeps me going, that somebody who doesn't have something would, you know.
And what's your daily routine, like business and home? The girls face many problems. Like, how would you say, did you face any problem in your field?
No, so I was always very independent and I was always very fearless. I never had any fear of going out, even if it was dark or night or, you know, going
not
alone. But yes, it is expected in this field to go out. You know, you can be expected to go out at night, early morning hours, anytime. And you can, you know, you might have to go a long distance, meet some new people. So you never know. And, you know, I was always very confident and fearless. But then there are girls who might not have been raised very independently, so for them it's not very easy to,
yeah,
you know, just go out into the big bad world and face the world. But then you have to be prepared for it.
In any field there's just like ups and down, success,
yes,
and the low. How did you face them? How did you balance them, the low limits?
So like I said, I was kind of lucky, you know, throughout my career. There were times when I had tough bosses, but then that really helped me to emerge stronger and, you know, learn from the lessons and do my best in my job. And there were times when probably I was a tough boss. So, you know, then even then you learn to, you know, that you have to work as a team.
Yeah.
That's very important. And there were times when I worked with small kids at home and I'm at office, and then you are, you know, kind of multitasking. You're calling home, you're making sure they've eaten, you know, they're well fed, they're well taken care of. Basically, other than that, nothing really big. And thankfully, it has all been going fine for me.
What's your fitness secret? You look so young. You have two children also.
Yes, I have two children. My daughter is 18. No, so I wish I was more fitter, but then I do try to, you know, put in power yoga in my work schedule. I begin at 8 to 9. I do my power yoga. I do 5 times a week. It's not very easy to keep up to it. Sometimes I miss. I'm not very regular. But then what happens is I go out a lot and I tend to eat out a lot. So that gets, you know, very unhealthy, which is not good. The best is to have a healthy vegetarian meal at home, but it doesn't really happen all the time. Weekends we are always out, and in my job we do have to go out and, you know, meet interesting people. So
how many days you are doing power yoga, ma'am?
It's been about a year I've been doing power yoga, and I really feel a lot of difference.
Yeah,
I feel a lot fitter, a lot stronger, and a lot more flexible.
You have met many celebrities and,
yeah,
interviewed them. How,
yes,
was those experiences?
Oh, it was wonderful. Some of the best names, I think, in Bollywood, Tollywood, Mollywood, Collywood, as,
wow,
you know, wherever, even Hollywood, I've met a few. So, yeah, it's been a very, very interesting journey. But one person who really remains special in my memory was Aamir Khan.
I love him.
Yes. He's a sweetheart, you know. He was so humble. I can never forget. You know, there are stars and, you know, it's okay if they have tantrums. But this guy, he was so humble. He kept saying thank you. He, you know, made me so comfortable. And that is a quality I really cherish. And, you know, people who are really big are always grounded. I've always seen that the bigger the star, the more humble they are. The struggling ones are always, you know, trying to throw tantrums. Yeah. It's always like that. I've always seen that. So I think that's very important to remember where you've come from. You know, be grounded, be humble, be modest. You don't lose really anything.
Some of them don't think.
Yes.
As a successful woman, what would you like to say for girls for motivating?
So, yeah, first of all, we are all equal. There's nobody, you know, higher or lower. Girls can do more than any boy can do. And we all know that. We've seen by example. There's so many examples. There's a long list of, you know, if I start now, it will go on forever. But I would say, you know, a girl should always support each other, stand by each other, and, you know, not get into the smaller things of life, but look at the bigger picture of life and how we can make this world a better place to live in. It might sound cliched, but that's how it is.
Ma'am, you have seen any girl like coming up from the down? We'll play one small game like rapid fire.
Rapid fire, okay.
Or if what comes to your mind suddenly.
All right, sure.
From Bangalore.
Bangalore, it's my go-to city. I love Bangalore.
Family.
Family is everything.
Business.
Business? Nope. Okay. Business is writing. Business is passion for writing. Okay, kids are my world.
Fashion.
Very important to survive in this world.
Lifestyle.
Lifestyle. Don't need to be very flamboyant to, you know, show others. But at the same time, it's important to, you know, be presentable.
Ma'am, what about the food?
Food habits, keep it healthy, and food that makes you strong and tasty, of course.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Manisa. Thank you. It was wonderful meeting you.
Yeah, I'm so nice to meet you. Thank you so much for spending a memorable time with us.
Thank you for coming all the way.